Welcome to our channel Coding Solutions. In this video, I am going to discuss about the multiple inheritance. What is multiple inheritance? Okay, multiple inheritance. So I will firstly let me create a class. Class, suppose I give your calculation. Calculation, okay. Let me write here calculation 1. Suppose I am writing calculation 1, okay. This is my base class. Remember this. This is my base class. Now I do sum. I am creating a method. Sum self a comma b. Okay. That's it. And now return a plus b. Okay, that's it. Now I will create another base class. Class calculation 1. Okay, let me make this as 2. I've already done 1. Let me make this as 2. Okay. Now another method to be called, and here I write multiply self a comma b. Okay. So these are my two base class. Remember this. These are my two base class. Now what I should do? Return what should I write? A into B. I am doing a multiplication, so I am writing A into B. Okay. Now what I will do? Now I will create the derive class. Just write here. For your information, for your understanding, let me write here derived only, not divide. I am writing a derived only. I will do the division here, but I am writing derived so that you can understand very clearly. So the derived class will inherit both the base class. Calculation 1 and calculation 2 are my base class, and both the classes will be in the derived class. Okay, this is the multiple inheritance. So what should I write here? Calculation 1, calculation 1, comma, calculation 2. That's it. Calculation 1, comma, calculation 2. Okay, that's it. Let me show you again so that you can understand it. Done, that's it. Derived class will inherit both the base class. Base class means calculation 1 and calculation 2. For understanding, let me write here base. And here also let me write here base. Okay, you will have a clear understanding. Now let me do another method. Let me name this as divide. Divide, okay. Self a comma b. That's it. Now what should I do here? Return a by b, right? A by B. Okay, that's it. Now what should I do? I will call the derived class. I will call the last class. For your easy understanding and a trick, I will call the last class derived. Okay, now just simple. Now let me calculate also. I will call and I will calculate also, and print it and calculate. Okay, I will call, print and calculate. So I am writing at print, and here d dot sum I'm calling, okay, remember this d dot sum 10 comma 20. Okay, done. I called it and I have passed the value 10 comma 20. Okay, print d dot what multiply d dot multiply, okay, and here also 10 comma 20. Okay, that's it, done. And print d dot divide, I'm keeping the same value, okay, 10 comma 20. That's it. Okay, there is an error. Oh, I made a mistake here. Here should be calculation 2. Now it's perfect. See, 30, 200 and 0.5. The mistake was that I wrote both times calculation 1. It should be calculation 1 comma calculation 2, because these are the two base class. So in multiple inheritance, what I did, I created two base class and then a derived class, and in derived class I inherited both the base class. That's the multiple inheritance. In the derived class I have to inherit both the base class. That is about the multiple inheritance. By this we end this video. If you have any queries, just comment, I will obviously reply. Thank you for watching this video. Stay safe, stay healthy.